In this video, I'm gonna explain how to perform an interactive cloth simulation, like the one I'm doing right now. This is very simple to do. First, I'm gonna create a new plane, scale it slightly and subdivide it. It's important to remember that after scaling an object, we need to apply transformations, since fabric simulations depend on the measure units, and not doing this could create some issues. Now, I'll create a plane and give it a little volume, to use this mesh as a collision object. I'll go to the physics panel and add a collision modifier, so the cloth can collide with it. To the plane, I'll add the cloth modifier. For now, I'll leave the options as default, since this video is about interacting with the cloth simulation, but maybe I'll do a future video explaining the cloth settings. Now, this plane already has cloth physics. If I press play, we can see that it falls down, but we can move it in any way. To fix this, I'll enter edit mode and select one or more vertex, depending on how we want to grab our fabric. I'll add this corner vertex to a vertex group. Now, I'll select the vertex or vertices I want to use to grab the cloth. Press F3 and search for hooks. I'll select the hook to new object, that way it will create automatically an empty object, and add the modifier to the cloth plane. You can do this with all the geometry you want and create different hooks. In the modifiers panel, I'll specify that it has to affect our vertex group. It's important to move this modifier before the cloth simulation, or it won't work properly. Now, it's also important to add the vertex group to the pin group option inside the cloth simulation. With all done, the simulation should work as intended, and moving the hook while calculating the simulation will move the cloth freely. If we want to add different hooks, we'll have to add new vertices to the vertex group, select only those vertices and again the command hook to new object. Now I'll make sure that the adjustment is again before the fabric simulation, or it won't work, and moving this will take only the selected vertices. If I change the modifier's position, now the simulation works fine, and we have two handles to modify the object the way we want. Occasionally, when working with this type of simulation, it's important to have enough frame duration and timeline. If our end frame is too short, we'll barely have time to move, and the simulation will reset before we finish, so make sure to give it a fairly high value. On the other hand, the amount of frames in our cache are also important. If there are too few, when they run out, the simulation will freeze, even if the animation timeline continues. So these two values are important to work the way we want. And that will be all for this video. In the future, I'll try to make more videos about cloth simulations and how to work with them. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.